they are, what class they're in.
This is my center, Briley Fly. She's a sophomore. And this is Eliana Ramsey. She's also a sophomore. She's going to move up to guard this year.
Jason's in his third season at Wilson Central. 19-13 last year. Lost to Cookeville in the region quarters. Jason, if you would, just an overview of what you've got coming back.
We lost our exchange student. We lost Rita Planea. And aside from that, pretty much have everyone coming back. Everyone was a sophomore. Everyone was a freshman last year. So we're basically sophomore laden and, you know, just looking to improve on what we did last year even more.
How was the off-season work, summer, that sort of thing?
I really don't think we had much time off. You know, I made the comment today, we don't do much on Fridays, but every other day of the week, we're rolling, doing something. If we're not on the track, we're in the weight room or getting shots up in the gym. So the girls have done a great job just working their tails off.
Summer leagues, play days, that kind of thing. How'd you guys play?
You know, aside from the high school season, they're playing AAU nonstop, okay. All of them. But I tried to play a lot more difficult teams over the summer and requested more difficult schedule to get more, you know, more of a concept of what our district looks like. You know, our district's so tough. I wanted to continue with that competition level. So we were about 50-50 on the summer for most of the part.
Just a sophomore, Ms. Fly, how has your off season been, and what are you looking forward to getting ready to get started?
Our off season has been good. We've done a lot of conditioning and working out, and I'm really excited for our season. We have a lot of people coming back, and our freshmen are going to be a really big part of our team this year, and we're just ready to compete.
Jason, when you guys are playing the way you want to play, what kind of style are folks going to see from Wilson Central? You going to play 94 feet? You're going to...
We did a lot of different things last year, and, losing Rita is really going to change a lot of things. So we're going to actually look to find an identity early. We've got a transfer come in that's going to shoot the ball pretty well for us. And, you know, I really don't want to come up here and tell everybody what we're trying to do all year long with the entire
like
room.
It's not like they're going to watch film, right?
You're right. So
film will be out there.
Yeah, you got a lot of great coaches in this room, so they'll all figure us out like they have anyways. But, you know, just like everybody, we look to push a tempo and hopefully shoot the ball well.
I'm blanking on your name, young lady.
Eliana.
Eliana, what are your expectations for this season before practice really gets rolling? What are your thoughts?
My expectations are high for the season, considering we have so many people coming back this year and only losing a few players, and our team has been playing together forever, so we're so bonded at this point that I'm just excited to see where the season goes.
And you guys played good basketball toward the end of the season. Jason, do you feel like you were playing your best at that time?
Absolutely. You know, we had a real close game there late in the district tournament with Cookeville, and they pulled away from us late, and, inevitably we lost to Oakland there in the region, but you know, we started clicking, started making free throws a big thing, stopped turning the ball over. And, you know, all those freshman mistakes we made earlier in the year really stopped.
Is there a certain amount of patience that you have to have coaching a young team like this?
Absolutely. You know, but the testament to them, they've been together a long time. As Eliana mentioned, you know, they all played at Glaville together, and I basically took the Glaville starting five and put them on the court last year, and you know, they're bonded. They are. They know where each other is. They're looking for each other, and they play well together.
Questions from our media contingent. Jeff, you or Andy, got anything you want to ask this coach?
I was going to ask Coach Andy, go four wins the first year, and you almost
was at Columbia State with Lewis Connor for a few years as an assistant, and then East, and then Summit, and now here. So I'm not really heartbroken about Coach Rigsby's loss of the 6'7 guy. I'll try to contain my sadness there. But Coach Rigsby and I are really good friends. We've known each other since Cannon County and have a lot of respect for him and what he does. I used to play him. We played while we were at Summit. He's had some talented guys. I know the Carters can really fill it out up. I got a dose of that a couple years ago when he was younger. It's going to be a challenge. It's going to be fun, but that's why we play the game. We want to compete. We want to see how we measure up and stand up to our competition and what we can do to make adjustments to be successful.
Andy, going back to your style of play, it sounds like you will, and you've been running a lot in preseason for conditioning purposes. Would you expect to see a 94-foot game then?
Well, ideally, yes. But I'll just say that in my history, I went a four-day span where I won a game 13-12 in overtime and turned around and played a school with five Division I athletes and beat them 86-73, something like that. So my focus is not on my style of play. I'm not worried about myself. I'm worried about how our team can be successful. So if we were to have to hold the ball, so be it. That's not ever going to be my initial plan, but as my opponents make changes, I make changes. So one of the things I would say about our program is we're going to be adaptable and adjustable, and we're going to make changes necessary to give us the best opportunity to win.
That's Wilson Central and Coach Jim Fay. Thanks, Coach. Thanks,
Thank
guys.
You. Appreciate it.
Players Jada Bernard and Andy Ward. Ladies, welcome. Mm-hmm. 17-13 last year. Coach Starkey, how has this team been over the summer? Talk about the summer work.
Okay.
What you were able to do with these girls.
We played BCAT, Lebanon, and Riverdale. And I guess we could say we played fairly well. You know, there were some games that I thought got away from us that we should have won, but, you know, that's always going to be the case. But as a veteran team, I think we call ourselves a veteran team. We got six seniors, all returners, only losing two seniors from last year. One started, we lost our twins last year, and they alternated starting spots. So for the most part, our core group is back, and the summer was perfect time for us just to continue building on what we built last year.
Coaching a veteran bunch, is that, I'm not going to say easier, but you know what they can do, and they've got a pretty good idea of what you want, right?
I think so, yeah. I think having 1 year under the belt with this group is moving towards them understanding how I want to play the game, yeah.
Your non-district schedule, talk about that. Are you going to be doing some traveling, yeah, tournaments?
Yeah, right off the bat, we're going to Memphis. We play Bartlett and then Middle College at Bartlett. And then we turn around and play the Siegel Stars Classic at Siegel, and then go back to Cleveland and play Bradley Central and not Bradley Central. We play Lincoln and somebody else at Bradley Central. I can't remember who that is right now.
That's pretty serious.
Absolutely, yeah.
Outside of the district, which is a battle every time you play.
I think, I'm still learning the girls' game in Tennessee, but I think having 1 year under the belt, I have a pretty good grasp of what a good, high-quality girls' basketball program looks like in Tennessee. And so having that, I feel pretty confident saying that. And I've told the girls this, we want to be one of the best teams in the state of Tennessee. So,
Jada, how has your preseason gone? You ready to get rolling?
I'm still recovering over my knee injury I recently had. And just been getting checkups and updates about it. So we're getting ready to start.
Well, so you're not turned loose to go full practice yet, or are you close?
Getting there, but
okay.
She's had a couple full practices, but we're just playing it slow right now.
Oh, well, that's wise.
Yeah. We'll just add to Jada what she brings. She's a tremendous skill player. Obviously, she brings a lot of size to the team. She leads our team in blocks, and I think if things go well, she'll probably lead the district for sure, region for sure, maybe even the state in blocks per game and total blocks on the season. So irrespective of the knee, obviously, you know, we want her to be healthy, but she's the type of player that she can still bring an impact, even being 75%.
Now, as you mentioned, the block shots, and I see a lot of sports throughout the year, you are fearless blocking shots. You don't, I mean, some people are concerned about picking up a foul. You're going for the block, right?
Yes.
You got some hops on you.
Thank you.
You got hops?
Just a little bit.
Camden, what are you looking forward to with this season right on top of us now?
I'm looking forward to winning games. I think we got a really good team this year. We got a new transfer, Izzy Hodge. She came to the team this year, and I think she's really going to help put us, like, in perspective, like, of how we play as a team. Like, everybody can play their role now. And I think she'll get us, like, good down the court, you know, so everybody can do what they're good at doing. So,
what's the best part of your game?
My game? I think I'm versatile.
Good work.
I think that's the best part of my game.
You think you can guard just about anybody, any position?
You know what I'm saying? I might have to put a hand out on somebody a little faster than me. But other than that, I'm good.
Yeah.
Basketball is a pretty big thing at Stewart's Creek. I mean, kids have kind of gotten into it.
Okay.
That makes it a fun thing, doesn't it?
Yeah. I agree. Yeah. I think it could be bigger, but we'll take that. Yeah, basketball is a big thing at Stewart's Creek. Yeah.
Questions, fellas?
I'm asking Coach. I know the creature down in the state now. It's a great girl.
Say it again? Oh, yeah. Pellet Sippy State. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
They did. Almost beat them, yeah. 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 Okay. Oh, yeah. That's right. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. The transition's been about as smooth as it could possibly be. And as good as she is at volleyball, she's way better at basketball. So whatever you saw. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I want to play basketball.
Oh yeah. Yeah, but basketball is her thing. She her level of skill and understanding of the game is impressive.
Okay. Talk about having a multi-sport athlete. That's a lot of people love that, and some people don't like having the share.
Well, there's not a lot of overlap from where I come from in Texas. The overlap between volleyball and basketball is pretty significant, whereas here there's not a whole lot of overlap. So, yeah, it's over today. Yeah. So I don't know all the logistics to it, but the transition from one sport to another in Tennessee seems to go much better than it does in Texas so far.
Let me ask this.
AAU for basketball.
Yeah. I know a lot of volleyball players, they play club volleyball, and it seems like it's basically county.
Okay.
I don't see a lot of elite players in
some interesting.
Just naturally good
players. Well, yeah, you're looking at one.
But if they're looking to go to the next level, then they probably, in volleyball, then they probably play club volleyball. And
right.
Coincides with basketball.
Yeah. Yeah, just to go back to our twins brought a lot to the team, but in terms of leadership, this one right here is maybe the best leader I've ever been able to coach. Every way. I mean, I brought things to Cam in terms of how the team should function and personnel situations that I've never brought to other players, and her wisdom and insight and her ability to translate the things that I'm trying to coach
to her teammates has been really good. And you know, she mentioned Izzy. Izzy's going to bring a big she's going to be good for us. And a lot of the reasons why Izzy is going to fit in really well is because of her leadership. So. Oh, yeah. Layla's an absolute dog. If I could bring three girls here, Layla would be here, too. Yeah. Layla is, yeah. Yeah, she's legit.
Camden, having a good group of seniors on this basketball team, naturally, they kind of have to lead the young ones and get them the way coach wants them to play. Is that something that you enjoy, having a leadership role on this basketball team?
Yeah, because it feels good to, like, have people who look up to you. You know, getting that, having the responsibility to, like, to help people, and they look for you to help them. So that's pretty cool. And I think they all trust me. They all trust my insight and the things I have to say. And they know it's coming from a place of, like, love. So, yeah.
All right. Anything else, guys?
Well, I thought you have six seniors. I guess four returning starters. And I don't know what you have coming up.
Okay.
Do you feel like this is your year?
Yeah, without a doubt. Yeah, this group of seniors have been together. Some of them have played together since sixth grade, and including Izzy. They've all played with Izzy, so Izzy's not necessarily a foreign concept to us. But, yeah, this is a big year for us for sure. Yeah. And like I said before, and I told the girls, there's no reason why we can't be one of the best teams in the state of Tennessee.
All right. Hey, thanks. That's Stewart's Creek. Appreciate it, guys. Coach Jones, first year head coach of Stewart's Creek, longtime assistant. You worked with a buddy of mine, Matt Bradshaw.
Yep.
Tell you how old I am. I covered him when he was Little League All Stars in this town.
Because he's old too.
Yeah. So you know how old he is.
Yeah.
talk about the transition after being an assistant coach to now having your own operation.
Well, first of all, I'm going to introduce my kids. Brought two seniors here, Cam Nelson, who's been with us for 4 years. Huge glue guy, big locker room guy, pretty much anything that you ask him, he's going to do. Then I brought Mike and Shaw, who's been our starting point guard for the last, you know, few years. Coach Rutland, Coach Smith probably think, you know, this is a seventh year senior by now, like he's still here because he's looked like this since his freshman year. But we're going to ask a bunch out of both of these. The transition is pretty easy. I mean, I've been around basketball my entire life. Basically, you know, did college stuff for a while. Learned a lot under Casey Alexander, who's the head coach at Belmont. I was on his staff for 6-7 years. Then transitioned to high school, worked for Jeremy Moore at Laverne, and then moved over to Stewart's Creek, where I worked for Howard Pride and then Matt Bradshaw, and then got the job. So, I mean, it's natural. There's no huge surprises, except now more paperwork. That's pretty much all that it's changed.
Will folks notice a big change in style of play for your basketball team?
It's gonna depend. We're gonna rely a lot on execution, you know. But at times, yes, we will fly up and down the floor. We got a lot of depth. We're senior heavy, but it's gonna be kind of game by game. But ultimately, execution is gonna come down to what we're gonna hang our hat on, basically. So it's gonna be a little bit different, you know. Obviously, might not notice it that much, but it's going to be a bit of a change for the kids a little bit, yes.
Micah, point guard, running the show out front, a lot of responsibility goes with that. Talk about your role with the basketball team.
My role is like leadership. You know, I keep all my guys, you know, together, keep their head level-headed and, you know, keep them together.
And that even translates off the floor into the locker room, I guess weight room, all that kind of stuff, right?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Karn, what kind of offseason?
Cam,
I'm sorry. What kind of offseason have you had? You feel like you got a lot of work in?
Yes, sir. Conditioning, I think we can get up and down the floor. Everybody can. And, yeah. But
how has the change been for you having a new guy as the head coach?
Well, I've been with him since my freshman year, so I have chemistry with him already.
So not a big change for you.
No, sir.
What about you, Mike?
It's the same
transition.
It's the same, really. He's been my coach since my freshman year. You know, we've been with each other for a long time. You know, he knows me, and I know him pretty well.
that's what's made the transition a little bit easier. I mean, these kids have been through three coaches now in 4 years, so it's pretty difficult on high school kids. But thankfully for Dr. Harrell and Coach Harris, the athletic director, they picked me, which I think is it makes an easy transition because we're so used to each other.
And stability for young guys is important. And
correct.
You're not just building for this year. You're looking years down the road.
Correct. Yeah. I mean, I think, again, with our senior-led group, I think they're going to set a good standard to make this transition very easy. And then that kind of falls in line with the younger kids as we move forward and all that. So I'm excited about it.
Schedule outside the district, what does that look like for you guys?
Well, we open up with Independence, defending state champions.
Good schedule.
Yeah, I did that. That was smart. First game of my coaching career. I'm 0-0 right now as a head coach, and we'll see how that goes. No, but yeah, undefeated. And then we have Brentwood on the schedule as well, Nolansville. I like to get over on that Wilco side just because it's kind of a different style of basketball that you know, we don't see a ton of just height-wise. I don't know why on earth they're so big over there, but they are, and that's going to help us as we move forward. We'll be a little shorthanded the first couple weeks. Coach Caudill and the football team's having a great season, and they're going to make hopefully a deep run in the playoffs. And we got two, three high-minute guys that still play football. But we're deep with our senior class, so we'll be competitive, very, very competitive to start the year. And that's just going to get us ready for district play because we know this district's going to be super competitive. Like Coach Fay was saying, there's no real bottom feeder. It's kind of – we're all kind of there. So you play those tough teams to start, and then we'll get our full team back ready to go, and then we'll be off and running.
Talk about that multi-sport athlete and what they bring to the table, because some folks don't, you know, say, I want my guys all
yeah,
the time.
Yeah, high school, I mean, I'm a believer of play as many sports as you can. You know, figure out what you love, what you're good at. Like, we have a kid that he's a senior this year, Taj Roseburg. He decided to play football this year. He hadn't played since his freshman year. He's been killing it. You know, he has an offer from a Division III school already in football, but he's still invested in basketball as well. But I think it's you get multiple sports. It's just good for the kids. You get different things. You don't get burnt out on one thing. And then the football kids are great. They're basketball kids too, and they'll be ready to rock and roll when they come back.
They come in good shape.
Yeah, exactly. You know, it's not quite basketball shape, but they'll be ready to go.
Ready to beat and bang.
Yes, absolutely.
Questions from our media guys?
I'm going to catch two seniors. I'll talk about how a few years ago, what was it like making their from 5 years ago? You're not blasting out. They did like 12 or 13. How many sessions?
It will take, a lot of discipline, a lot of hard work and dedication for us to get back to where we want to be. Yeah, it was pretty fun.
They were freshmen, so they didn't. I mean, they were around it, but not,
yeah, no, not but, yeah,
clearly involved in it. But
I grew up too. Like, we didn't have experience on varsity freshman year, but I love being around it. So,
anybody else?
I guess you would ask the girls, so many seniors and returning players eventually.
Mm-hmm.
You've been there.
Mm-hmm.
It's
set up for it, yes. We have a great group. If this is a year where we can make a run, definitely. Now we got some good younger kids too. We have Sean Goggins, who's going to be a sophomore this year. He started almost every game for us last year. But collectively up top, yes, senior led, and just as a group, we should be very, very competitive to have a really good year. We have high expectations going with that, and hopefully those are met. And we'll go from there. But yes, this year should be the year where we could be very competitive with a bunch of things.
Coach, I guess I know the private recruitment you live in down in the future.
We've talked. He's actually back in Tennessee now.
East Hamilton.
We actually talked the other day. Yeah, schedule's full. He was talking about a scrimmage, but. we're kind of full with that. But yeah, in the future, I think we can get together and do a home at home or something, because it's good to get down there too and play those teams. Like I said, we're doing a bunch of Wilco this year, kind of outside the district. But in the future, yeah, I would like to get down to Chattanooga and play some of those teams as well, just to kind of get a big landscape of everybody and see everybody as we move forward.
And that's Stewart's Creek. Thanks, man.
All right. Thank you all. Thank you.
Coach Lonnie Drayton, introduce your players you've got with you today first.
I've got Jakiya Herrera right here. This is a junior, two-year starter right here. And Tanaja Johnson, we call JJ, and we call this Nana. But Tanaja Johnson, who's a four-year starter, senior right here.
Okay. How has the offseason been for Smyrna basketball?
We did a lot of practice, and we did a lot of taking care of things internally, working on the things that we really need to work on. The fundamental aspect of the game, the discipline aspect of the game, The one thing with this team, is that there's not a lack of hunger. There's not a lack of desire. I would put this team up against anybody as far as scrappiness is concerned. I mean, this team is going to continue to fight. That's just the mentality. That's just the Smyrna culture, the Smyrna mentality, and it's embedded in these girls right here. That's why I brought these two with me, because, as far as stature, you look at them and you're thinking, smallest two kids probably in this facility right here. But, we're going through a dark alley right here. These are two I'm taking. Those are just these type of kids right here.
When they get to your building as ninth graders, do you feel like you've got to kind of start fresh with them? Are they getting a good foundation at the middle school level?
It's started to get a lot better. We've got some coaches that we were able to put in at Smyrna Middle. One of our former player, Diamond Forrest, her father is taking over the Smyrna Middle program. She was, a Division I college player and played at Smyrna. And, her dad is doing a good job. So our incoming freshmen will be a huge part of our program this year. A lot of talent. We've got three or four of them with more talent than I've seen in a long time. But they'll be, and with him pushing that and at Rocky Fork, and we get a lot of feeder. I mean, we've got a couple of college, high schools that are feeder programs. I mean, middle schools that are feeder programs to our high school right there. So it's kind of a big, it's really important as those coaches are contacting me, wanting to come to our practices in the summertime, want me to help out and give them, points of emphasis. And, so I think in the long term, it'll help our program a lot, build us back up.
If the game's going like you want it, how many kids are you going to play on an average night?
Like we want it, we would play 10 or 11 on an average night.
Up tempo.
The reason being is because, as you can see, we're small. So we have to buy into the program, to the aspect of we have to play fast. Anything in a half-court set, we may be in a little trouble because we're not very big. But we're going to pressure you and pressure you and pressure you and hopefully, burst some pipes as we're doing it, so.
You kind of talk about playing for Coach. What does he expect from you, and what do you like about playing in his program?
That he's a very disciplined coach. So he'll time us, and if we don't make it, we have to redo it until we make it. And it really gets the girls, energized and desperate, to make shots more. This year, I feel like our shots have been on spot. And the freshmen this year are a big weapon to us since we're small. Our scrappiness will be 10 times as much as it was than last year. And yeah, I feel like this year is going to be one of the years we continue to grow.
Steps.
Yeah, make steps.
And I'm blanking on your name.
Tanaja Johnson.
What's your role on this basketball team? What do you bring to the table for Smyrna?
I am a four-year Smyrna Bulldog, and since freshman year, I've been a leader. Like, I bring a lot to the table, and I just see the potential in the teams as the years go by, and I just want better for the teams. And I'm a senior this year, it's my last year, so senior year is really big to me. And this team, I feel like connection-wise and the chemistry and stuff. Like, it's going to run deep. Like, these girls came in ready. Like, there's not a day where they don't want to put in any type of work. Like, they're just dogs, and I see a lot in this team. And we play fast. We have the ability to, like, the districts that we play this year, like, they're fast, and this team can keep up, and we're not going to slack. Like, we just go, and all coach asks is for effort and to push, and this team wants better this year, and I feel like this year is going to be a big one for us because we're ready to play. And
yeah. And I'm going to add something. As far as Nana right now, we call her Nana, but Tanaja, she is one of the smallest players in our district. And if you ever look at our team, if you've watched us play, you know, she's one of those kids, if we play an overtime game of 40 minutes, she might have to play 40. You know, she's a point guard, she's a leader. But here's the thing is, a lot of kids, you see that they want to play 30 minutes. They want to play 32. They don't want to come off the court. But their effort is lacking in the fourth quarter. You know, when you play all those minutes, if you look at this kid, it is, you know, the first minute of the game, she is picking up baseline to baseline. In the 30th minute of the game, she's picking up baseline to baseline. It's just, I mean, it's just every sprint she runs in practice, every in conditioning, every single time, it's all out, maximum effort. And, you know, these two kids, they're both built like that. But, you know, you can't really, you know, it's unmatched. It's sort of crazy, you know, because people look at records sometimes. And they look at, but they don't look at the effort. They don't look at, you know, just the buy-in process of these kids. And these kids, they don't have it easy. You know, like a lot of kids, a lot of programs, they have it, you know, the kids have it easy. They got mom and dad taking you to this AAU team, this is self-preservation. This is kids going in and doing what they have to do because they want to change the mentality for themselves. You know, not only the program, you know, she wants to change it for herself. So, you know, coaching these type of kids, I'm the head softball coach, and I've got, you know, the difference in both worlds. And coaching these type of kids, I'll take that hand.
It sounds like you're having a lot of fun with this.
It's awesome.
Yes.
I love it.
We push the girls to go hard. I'm a senior, like I said. I played these schools two or more times. And my experience with these teams, I let the girls know, like, what they're getting into and how we can evaluate and make, like, better decisions than how last couple years played out. And I feel like these girls have the heart to go in and actually fight because people may underestimate us, but they don't know how, like, the type of work that we put in, and we actually try and we actually, like, play, and we're willing to go against anybody. Like, we have the heart to play like dogs, and this year our girls are going to come out, and I just hope that we shock the district this year.
Ja'Kai, it's sometimes frustration sits in when things don't go well. How is it tough to fight that and just, hey, turn that off and let's go on and let's move on in the game? How do you handle things like that?
Normally, when my shots don't go in, like in practice, I'm frustrated. Coach tells me I'm frustrated. I can't get frustrated when the team depends on me. So I push it aside, take a couple of deep breaths, and I continue to work and strive. And then eventually my shots will fall, and then I'm satisfied.
And sometimes if it's not going from outside, take it to the rack, try to get a layup in there, mix it up a little bit.
Yeah, a little foul.
Yeah.
To the free throw.
Media guys, questions? I'm going to talk to you after I know one of your teams. Last year you played softball and pitching now at A&M now. That's the key. They're really good at me. I mean, you've got to do more about the same. I mean, kids who play both of these last year, who's really good at me. I know she's a big leader. What have these two bring leadership that she brought last year? Y'all be a little bit better than you were this year.
I'm gonna tell you, Destiny was a big loss because of that mentality. But as far as leadership is concerned, you know, even last year you had to look to these kids as leaders. You know, we lost to Ati Norman, who was a leader. But I'm going to these kids right here, and a mix of, you know, we can only bring two, so we had to leave behind a few others that, you know. But I'm gonna tell you, it's just the mentality of you know, I'm working for the girl next to you. I'm working for the sister. My sister next to you, you know, is the strongest on any team, any basketball team so far that I've ever coached. And, you know, these kids, you know, a lot of times you get teams, and I've been the head boys coach. I've been, you know, head girls coach. A lot of times you get teams where you have,
that mentality of I want to get mine. I want to, you know, I'm not so satisfied that, you know, they're in the locker room pouting after you win and because they only had 10 points. Well, these girls, I'm going to tell you, they hit a shot in practice. They hit a shot in any time when they're up and they're celebrating each other's success. You know, it's weird. It's like, it's something that people don't, you know, after they win, if they win a game right there, they're celebrating their sister's success.
I mean, I just think, mm-hmm.
I've been put in a blessed situation with our principal. You know, Dr. Sutherland has set me up to be successful in that regards. You know, I start the day off and we practice basketball in the mornings. And then we practice softball in the afternoons, you know. So it's just a blessing to have to do this and to not miss a beat. I mean, you go in and we're going. You know. Yeah, if it wasn't for Dr. Sutherland, I'd be exhausted and I wouldn't be able to do it. But, you know, our principal has set me up with and, you know, I'm just really blessed in that situation. She wants us to be successful. And then she, you know, the coolest thing about it is not only does she want your success, she wants you, you know, to be relaxed, to be comfortable, to be, you know, energized and excited. So if she sees stress, which, you know, when I'm doing this, like I tell people all the time, I could do it for 10, 15, and I teach sports history, so I could do it for 10, 15 more years, you know, if I need to, because it's fun. I mean, as long as I'm out here, the day I wake up and I'm like, and I dread to see these girls at basketball practice, that's the day I'm going to hang it up. I'm excited. I'm hyped. I'm going. I'm that way in softball. I'm both of them. You know, I am ready to practice. Okay. I'm hyped to be with these little girls. And you got talent, but awesome. That's right. It's hype. You know, I feel like I'm 26, not 46. That's right.
As you look around this district, how do you see yourselves fitting in going for this season?
This district is loaded. I mean, this district is loaded. I mean, I've known these coaches for forever, you know. And then Faye coming in here on the boys' side, I coached Faye against Faye when he was at East, you know, years and years ago, you know. And I grew up with Steve Carter back there, you know. You know, beat him one-on-one for years. But you know, I've known these, you know, known a lot of these coaches right here. And it's, you know, I told last year, you know, it was the same situation. We're going to be in a situation where we have to, we're going to struggle at times. They're just bigger, stronger. The thing I'm so excited about with coaching this is, you know, I respect every coach in it. The thing I'm excited about is the fact that, you know, when we pull up, you know, it's not an intimidation. You know, we may be overmatched. You know, we may be overpowered. We've got to, you know, in order to beat, you know, like I said, I don't know what they're drinking at Lebanon, but we're going to sneak some water over there. We're going to go drink it. You know, Cookville, we're going to do it too. You know, Stewart's Creek, we're going to do it. And they're in our backyard. They're right next to us. And why are there girls over here, you know, taller than you sitting on that thing right there? Our girls, you know, bless them. All right. So we're small, but we're going to go out there and as a coach, I'm going to stand up. I'm going to coach with fire and my players are going to play with fire. You know, there's a couple of times last year that I did show frustration and I got to reevaluate myself, you know, because I'm a competitor. I love to win. I love to compete. I love to win. But my girls, as long as they're fighting, as long as they're scrappy, as long as there's a ball on the ground that's rolling around and we're diving for it, you know, and guarding baseline to baseline, doing whatever we can, fourth quarter of a game, not peeking at the scoreboard, but peeking at what's the girl in front of us, I'm happy. I'm happy, and we're going to go in the locker room, win or lose, and I'm going to tell them I'm proud of them. So that's the mentality. They put it on the line for me. I'm going to put it on the line for them. And that's the mentality.
Thanks, Coach. Appreciate all right. it. Smyrna girls. Jay. Joe Marsh Smith in his fourth season at Smyrna. Coach, introduce your kids, please.
All right. To my left, I have Tyreek McCarver, senior, second leading scorer from last year, leading assist guy, probably our most tenured player as far as playing time. And then to my right is Jaleel Beatty Roberts, our leading returning scorer from last year, leading rebounder from last year. So this is who he's also a senior as well.
I've talked to everybody about the offseason. How has that gone for you and the Smyrna team?
Pretty good. If I had to guess, I'm probably the only one that say my two leading scorers hadn't had an off season because they're both playing football. So I hadn't seen them much. But the other guys have been in the weight room, conditioning, doing pretty good. So it's been a pretty good off season. We're excited, looking forward to it.
Summer, how did that go for you?
We had a good summer. Probably, you know, people don't keep up with the records, but. We had a winning record this summer, which was probably the first in a long time at Smyrna High School. Played some really good competition. We went down to Alabama, played against Hoover, who's the three-time defending state champion. Lost to them by like 5 or 6. So we had a good summer, and we saw some things that we could build on.
Tyreek, talk about, if you would, football's going on, big part of that operation. Are you able to slip a little basketball in, or are you all locked in football right now?
Kind of both. I'm locked in football fully, but I try to get in the gym sometimes too. But I don't try to do it too much because I don't want to get hurt for my team because I'm a leader for football too.
Was it? Did you play football all 4 years?
No, sir. I played last year and then I played this year.
Okay, so what made the decision? I know football's strong in your family. Mm-hmm. There's no doubt about that. What made the decision? Hey, I'm gonna put on the helmet, shoulder pads.
Well, I played football my whole life. I played freshman year. I just didn't play at Smyrna, and I didn't play sophomore year. I took a break because I was trying to focus on basketball. But then I realized that I missed football too much, and then I just wanted to put a helmet back on.
Yeah,
let me
say, Jaleel.
Yes, sir.
Same kind of question for you because you're playing though. Talk about that a little bit.
I transferred to Laverne my sophomore year. I played my freshman year. I played football, but I transferred, and I didn't really like the program at Laverne, so I didn't play football. Then I transferred back, and I missed my junior year. I missed my opportunity because I transferred too late. So then I came back my senior year because I had the opportunity to. So
Smyrna's kind of home, right?
Oh, yes, sir.
I mean, back here, what's it like playing with this bunch and being back with you guys?
Oh, it's my family. It's like chemistry there, like automatically. I've been playing with them for so long.
How, Coach Smith, how has this bunch been for Coach? I know you don't have your hands on these guys right now because they're with football, but how has this group been?
They've been fun. You know, anybody here that's a parent, you know how that is. You got your days where you want to strangle them, but you know they're good kids. They respond to coaching. You can tell that they are a very tight knit bunch. So they've been fun to coach. This is my first four-year senior class, and seeing these guys grow up, it's been very rewarding. Because I remember when I first got them, it was a struggle a lot of days. But now I'm not having to repeat myself as much and say the same things over and over. So it's been rewarding watching them grow.
How many seniors you got?
We've got 7 seniors this year.
Well, that's impressive because a lot of times, from the time they're playing ninth grade ball to the time they get to be seniors, a lot of kids decide they want to do something else. You manage to keep 7 of them pitched.
Well, and so, you know, I didn't have Tyreek his freshman year. He was at that school down there in Murfreesboro with the red, you know, the little football powerhouse. And he decided to come back and play with his brothers. And then there was a couple others that I didn't have. But for the most part, I've had most of them. But it's been, you know, it's been great watching them grow up, for sure.
Talk about the district as a whole, about where Smyrna kind of fits in there.
That's a good one. I don't know. Hopefully near the top. But I mean, I'm a realist. I Cookeville, even though they have a new coach, they were a state tournament team. They were state finalists last year. And that carries a lot of weight, regardless of who the new coach is and who they lost. Those guys played in the state tournament last year. They get it. You know, same thing with Laverne. They played in the state tournament. So, you know, they've got guys coming back who've been through that fire that we haven't been through. obviously, Coach McDowell as well. So we're navigating some waters that we haven't navigated yet. But, you know, on paper, I think we have a chance to really compete and make some noise. But like I tell the guys, paper burns and you can cut it. So, you know, talent is only going to take you so far. So, you know, we've been working hard, but I think we have the talent definitely to compete.
When Smyrna's playing the way you want to play, what style of basketball will folks notice from you?
You know, I've always been one who wanted to play fast, get up and down the floor. But, you know, one of the things I learned, especially these last couple of years, that may not always be the case with us. You know, we've had years where we were the second or third leading scorer in the region, and it didn't really translate to wins. So our big thing is now you're going to look at us and see how hard we play defensively and how greedy we're going to be on the defensive end of the floor.
Kyrie, talk about that defensive mindset Coach wants to bring to the table. Sometimes the shots aren't going in, but you can always guard them.
At Smyrna, we haven't been a very defensive good team, and I feel like that's why our win and loss column haven't been good. So we're going to try to do better this year because we're usually a score first mentality, but that hasn't done good for us. So this year we're going to really try to strap in on defense.
You got some wingspan on you. Who are you going to guard? Are you going to be guarding threes and fours or what?
Guard everybody. Anybody you put me on. Sorry.
And it's funny, you know, last year when we started the season, he was more of a three or a four. Our starting center went down early in the year, so he played five most of the year. But now if you look at our roster this year, we're very big. We're probably the biggest team in the district. So hopefully he's not having to play the five. I mean, he's long, but he ain't got the most meat on his bones either. So hopefully we can get him more of his natural position so he's not having
to. Get him out on the floor.
Yes, right? Yes, for sure.
Questions, man?
No, not at all. You know, we, like I said, we got our 6'7" kid, Jordan, Clay Joseph, coming back. We got a couple other guys who moved in, 6'4", 6'6". So we got a lot of length, and we're going to try to utilize that. But like you said, we're talking about teams that have been doing this for a long time, who've had way more success than we've had, you know, in the past. But, you know, we're not going to let that deter us. We're going to continue to work and, you know, they say a rising tide lifts all boats. So we're gonna get ourselves up there with those guys. It's gonna depend on the night. I'll say that much. Right. I'll put it this way. You're not going to be able to watch one game film of us in scouts because it's going to look different night to night. We're going to do a lot of different things, so for sure.
I know that you have 6 or 7 seniors and you have some size. You said you're the biggest team in the district. Do you think this is the year you can get on the elevator and shoot up a bit?
I think we can. Like I said, I've been asked this question a few times, and I tell people – it makes me nervous because I don't want to say, well, we're going to do this, and then, you know, you come back in February and say, well, what happened? So, like I said, I think the potential is there for sure. It's not going to be easy by any means. So, you know, I'm not going to make a prediction and say we'll finish first or second or third. But just know that we're not going to look the same as last year. I can promise you that. They're going to be a lot better effort, more discipline, and just a harder working group.
Else. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Smyrna Bulldogs. Corey Baird, 10th year at Lebanon, 23-9 last year. Tiara Spencer, Ellie Beth McDonald, ED, as she's known. Corey, talk about the offseason a little bit. How is this bunch ready to get started?
Well, first, we had a major injury at the summer camp. T.K. Hastings, who was our co-MVP of the district, tore ACL the very last day of team camp. In a freak thing, like it happens, you know, way too much these days. But so I want to make sure I mention that. But she's had a great surgery, went well, rehab's going well. So we're expecting to get her back at some point during the season. So I want to say about that. As far as our team, we have high expectations. And I think one of the most important things for us is our toughness and then how we grow each day. And you know, people talk about wins and losses and things, and you know, the 9 you said of the 23-9, that just stings every time somebody says that. But in perspective, our players understand that it's a daily process, and that's what we've been doing. We've been working daily to improve, and we're on the right track.
Yara, talk about how competitive practice is at Lebanon when you guys are, of course, practice hadn't officially started yet, but what? It's competitive. I mean, you guys get after it, right?
Yeah, I feel like whenever we, like, practice and, like, work out, we're always, like, pushing each other, making sure everyone's talking, and making sure everyone's doing every single rep that we have. So, like, if we're playing against each other, someone's always talking to somebody. Like, it's pretty fun. But, like, we always push each other to work hard. So.
And E.B., you play a couple of sports. You play volleyball as well, coming off a good season with that. Are you able to jump right in? Do you feel like there's a little transition? Talk about that a little bit.
Yes, sir. I feel like I'm usually always ready to jump right in. I always look forward to basketball, especially because this is my second year and I know what to expect. You know, I love volleyball. I'll always love it. But basketball was my first sport, my first love. So I'll always jump right into it and be ready for it.
Shoot or shoot, right?
Yes, sir.
So you're ready to go?
Yes, sir, I am.
Tiara, what about this basketball team without TK, at least for a good part of the season? Will that change the dynamic any? Will you guys play differently or what?
I feel like losing TK was a really big hurt for our team, but all of our teammates have been playing with each other. Like, we've all played with each other at some point in our time, so we all know how to play together. So I feel like we'll be able to make it work out somehow. But I feel like we're going to be pretty good this year. We'll be all right.
And E.B., Corey wants kids that can guard them. I mean, he talks defense a bunch. How do you feel like – how are you on that aspect of your game, playing defense the way he wants you to play?
I'd probably say defense is probably my weakness. You know, I'm kind of like an offensive kind of player, but – you know, coming into my second year, I know what to do and, like, how to expect playing defense. You know, just keeping up with my own teammates during practice is a lot. We're a very fast-paced team, always get up the court. We move laterally very quickly, so I just got to keep up with them, and games should be easy.
Let me add to that. She's selling herself short defensively. She can do it, and she does do it. And as long as she believes she can do it, she will, every possession. So she can, and she will.
And there are some really good individual players in this district, in this room tonight. Corey, this district has got some dogs in it.
Well, you know, let me say, you know, all the student-athletes here, you guys are doing a great job up here. And it's refreshing to know that our young people are up speaking in front of people and stuff like that. So, you know, let me say kudos to you guys. You know, the thing with our team is it has to be about bonding. It has to be about togetherness. And I feel like, and these guys can tell you, that's something that's been a strength of ours this off season and in the summer and stuff like that. So I think we're on the verge of trying to take that next step and to the next level. We've been, by our standards, you know, it hasn't been where we wanted it to be. By other people's standards, it's been good. But for us, it has to be your best. And then wherever that falls, we'll let the chips fall where they may there. So we want our best every single day.
Talk about the non-district schedule. Who have you got?
Well, some fool made that schedule. But, no, I mean, we
We don't run away from anybody or anything, because we want to know whether it works out for us in the end. We want to know what our weaknesses are
early on.
We want to get them all out there for everybody to see, and so we know what we can do. We open up with Oak Ridge on a neutral side in Smith County. Then we've got Bradley Central coming here in Hall of Fame, which I don't think we have to say much about them. They're a different animal. Then we go to Memphis to Bartlett to their Thanksgiving thing. We're playing Hoover, Alabama, who won the state last year in Alabama. And then we come back for Thanksgiving and play Brentwood, who's going to be one of the top 4A teams in the state. And we got Blackman before Christmas. And then at Christmas, we got Innsworth, Lee Huntsville, Alabama, and then some of our rivals, Green Hill and Mount Juliet before that too, in Gallatin. So we're going to find out pretty quick where we are. We're not sure yet. The tournament we were supposed to go to and Destin got canceled, so we kind of just picked that up actually about 2 weeks ago, so the schedule hadn't come out with that yet. But we went down there 2 or 3 years ago and played great competition down there, so we expect it to be good for us and come back and get us ready for our district season.
Volleyball is kind of, I would have to say it's more laid back than basketball. You know, it's very competitive, but, you know, it's kind of like a high-five sport. You kind of just play around, and then you get a point and then high-five each other. But for basketball, and especially playing for Coach Barrett, it's always high speed. You know, he's always on my butt, and he's always on the rest of our teams. But, you know, he's always going to encourage us, just like Coach Pickler, my volleyball coach. But it's always high speed, and that's what I love about basketball and Coach Barrett.
You don't take any charges in volleyball, right?
No.
Anybody else?
Florida, you mentioned Colonel Florida was canceled. You said he replaced it with?
Yeah, Pensacola. Yeah, that should be on there. Yeah.
Pensacola.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's there. Okay.
Yes, sir.
The other thing I'm looking at, I know you have five seniors. I'm trying to count the managers.
Six, yeah.
There's five seniors. Like, it's been a while since heavy graduation.
Yeah.
You know, you built this thing over the past couple of years, and you have five seniors now. It seems like it's the big years, a young team. We have a sophomore sitting next to you.
Yeah, well, you know, a lot of games last year we started three freshmen. And, you know, but it's actually six seniors, but with TK out, five that are playing. Some of them have more experience than others. You know, Rodale started for the last 2 years. For us at the four, and we're expecting big things out of her. She came to media day last year, you know. But again, like you said, we still have a young team, because when you get, you know, and Tierra's a junior now, and we'll start two or three sophomores, two or three juniors, two or three seniors at various points. It'll basically be what you do in practice, and that's how we'll determine who's going to start, who's going to play, and then who's going to finish the game. But the good thing about that, the competition that you have every day in practice, the games should be easy. If you're pushing each other and you're trying to get the best out of each other, and it can get testy at times, for sure. But I think our kids understand once we cross the lines and go off the floor, everything's cool. But we expect them when they're inside the lines to compete like they would compete against anybody else.
And your deep, this reacts death.
Yeah, it does.
You're not starting.
Yeah, and the thing is, you know, if you don't bring it one day, you may end up not playing for a while. So, you know, that, and that's the thing. And for our teams, and Tommy was probably going to ask me, you know, defense is going to be our number one thing, because defense always travels. The game's going to slow down in the postseason, even though we want to play fast and long and athletic and get up and down and shoot it and pound the boards and things like that. You get in the postseason, you're going to have to slow that thing down. You're going to have to guard somebody in the half court, and you're going to have to get the rebound. And possessions are going to be valuable, you know, even more valuable when you get in the postseason.
You say quickness 6'2", maybe a 6'4", 5'11".
Yeah.
But I don't think of you as a big team either. You don't have a
Coach
Mason.
No, we don't. We don't. We're not overly big, but we're long. And as EB mentioned earlier, our lateral, we've got lateral quickness that's going to, you know, should be a big point of emphasis for us. We put a big point of emphasis on it in the weight room this year, this spring, this fall. It's something we do every day, and our speed and our strength. And the one thing I've been most impressed with our kids this fall is the buy-in in the weight room. We have made probably more strides with this team in the weight room than we have probably in the last 5 or 6 years.
That's a mindset, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I mean, you've got to go in there knowing I got work to do, let's get it done,
and
keep up with how much stronger you get. The numbers going up, that sort of thing.
Yeah, and that's the thing, too. We really changed how we did it. And I didn't know exactly the benefits it would pay off, but I see it when they're playing against each other. I see, and I don't always tell them that, but you see, you either going to punish or get punished. And, because basketball is a physical game. It's not going away. So I see that with our kids. Like Tierra, she's not very big in stature, but the strides she's made this fall has been tremendous. And this is a beast right here. I mean, she won't tell you, but she'll be going to work out at 4:30 in the morning at Sports World and then coming and practicing volleyball or working out with us, working out in the afternoon. She's doing that several times. And, people don't see that, and she don't tell anybody that, but I know what's going on, and it's, you can really see it. I mean, and on the court, it's going to make a big difference.
Anybody else? Thank you. Thank you, guys. Jim McDowell and the Blue Devils. Those taking notes, it is AAAA. Jim McDowell, 14th year at Lebanon High School. It doesn't seem possible, but again, I covered McDowell when he played basketball at Lebanon, and that tells you I'm on the back end of a rather mediocre career.
Hall of Fame.
Introduce you guys.
I've got senior guard Avery Harris, all-district selection last year, returning leading scorer, and senior guard Brody Reasonover, our leading returning three-point shooter. Coached Brody's brother, older brother Gavin. He's been in the gym since he was little. I've known these guys for a long time, and it's hard to believe they're finally seniors, but two good guys here with me today.
You feel like your basketball team made some strides last year, under 500 is the way you finished. You made it to the region quarterfinals. This team seemed to kind of gel as it went along last year.
Well, we were replacing seven seniors from the previous year. Avery and then one other guy, Chasen Dixon, were only two guys we had that had any varsity experience. And Chasen went down in the first half of our first game with an ACL. So we were really young. I was throwing guys out there last year, still had milk on their breath. I mean, they were young. A lot of those guys in previous years would have been playing JV, but they got thrown in the varsity fire. And we had a great league last year with Cookeville going to the state championship game and with Laverne going to the state tournament as well. So, there's no cupcakes there, but for our guys, we kind of grew up over the course of the season. Avery really came on and took charge offensively, and Brody's three-point shooting, and then some other guys we had step up. Now we've got eight guys coming back that have varsity experience. Marquise Anglin is a guy that started for us. TJ Searcy, Mari Manier came off the bench, got a lot of minutes last year as a freshman. Evan Clem. And so we've had a lot of guys, Cash Williams, another senior that's not here today. Feel like we're a lot further along right now going into the season than we were last year, and excited about the growth. We ended up winning four of our last six, ended up coming in third in the league, and then ran into a tough Siegel team, played them tight for about 3.5 quarters before they kind of got away from us at the end. But just being able to make it to the region with that group of guys, and have some postseason success playing those type games, I think is really going to help us going into this year.
Mr. Reason, over, talk about your game a little bit. You don't mind putting up a shot every now and then, do you?
No, sir, I don't. Especially with this summer, it's helped me a lot. AAU and even summer ball with Lebanon. I mean, I just played more freely, I feel like, this year, maybe because I'm maturing or whatever. But, yeah, I mean, I'm not afraid to shoot it, and he'll tell me that all the time. He'll get mad when I don't shoot it. So I just try to, you know, shoot the ball, and I'm trying to do more than that this year. So.
And there's a difference in taking a shot and taking a good shot, right?
Yeah.
Talk about that mindset for you.
Well, I kind of know that, but this year I kind of know my limits. He doesn't really care if I shoot, you know, 2 or 3 feet behind the line, anything like that, or if a defender's close to me. He knows what happens if I shoot it. But, I mean, there's just certain times in the game where you need to hold the ball, not shoot that shot. It's just kind of IQ.
Avery, I'm not trying to embarrass you, but I had an assistant basketball coach at another school grab me at a football game, and he says, I've scouted all the opponents. He said, I can't find anything that Avery Harris doesn't do well. You've made a lot of strides as a basketball player, haven't you? Talk about that a little bit, about your growth.
Well, I started basketball at a really young age, and I've always loved it. So, I mean, always had a good work ethic. I've always been in the gym. I feel like I can do anything on the court.
And it was like a mentality that you had that things started breaking down. You just put the ball in your arm, you kind of clear it out, and boom, there you went. Not everybody can do that.
Yes, sir. I mean, I feel like it's a confident thing. My confidence, I mean, has struggled sometimes, but I feel like I have it in the right spot right now, and I feel like I'm confident on the court.
How was your offseason?
It was pretty good. You know, always in the gym, always trying to be great at my craft. It's, I feel like all of that, all of us can do as players.
Jim, Corey talked about the schedule that some crazy guy put together. Talk about the before Christmas, some of the guys you're going to be playing.
Yeah, Corey talked me into going to play at Smith County for Hall of Champions, and said we were going to play Smith County or Pickett County, and then get a text message or 3 weeks later, what about playing Oak Ridge? So that's who we're opening up with, both of us at Smith County. We're also going over to Gallatin to play in Hall of Champions there, playing Gallatin in the regular season. Coach Luna, legendary coach there, playing Blackman as well. Coach Wertman, our county rivalry games that we've been able to instill as well with Mount Juliet and Green Hill. So, you know, we're going to be tested by the time we get into district play. These guys know what to expect. We're hosting some events as far as with Thanksgiving. We play Stone Memorial in that with Cade Capps, who was a Mr. Basketball finalist up there at Stone, who's a senior. I think he's a Trevecca commit. So, you know, we're going to be tested, but, you know, we're going to be tested night in and night out in this league. So try to make sure that we're ready when the time comes.
Fellas, I would say,
what was infamil, I believe. We were really young.
But I will say that you with you and the parents and look those who have y'all been there so long. Just talk about the place you call built up on the office, people, people, those don't some who stay around long like his wife. You've been there 14, very 10, all those been around 4 or 5 years. You got stuff like that. I mean, the bridge jobs, what about the higher coaches? You keep on rolling in. That's got a good bridge. People stay in one place long time.
Yeah, Lebanon is a special place. I mean, I grew up here, you know, played here, so I'm at my alma mater. Sometimes that's good, sometimes that's bad, but we've been able to have enough success that I've been able to stick around. You know, Coach Barrett and I, we have a great working relationship. It's rare to have coaches that are able to stay together as long, especially at one spot as we have. One thing that we have in common is we both work. We host a lot of things, whether it's middle school play days or elementary stuff or AAU or, you know, different events throughout the season. And if you don't get along with the person you're working with, that, that makes those things a lot tough to do. But we both work hard. We have mutual respect. And I think our teams have a mutual respect for each other. You know, our kids are, you know, we have this, they have the same class every day and they get to see each other. And, you know, we're pulling for the girls in their games and they do the same for us. And, you know, love his kids and our, he loves our kids. So also our administration, you know, Dr. Walter is our principal. And then we have, I think we have, no disrespect to anybody else, but I think we have one of the best athletic directors in the state of Tennessee and Zach Martin. And he does so much for us as coaches and fights for us and really cares about our school and our community and our program. So Lebanon's a good place to be.
And after one question, I know all of you actually you're playing representative this winter. I mean, you brought all of you. See, that's what that job is. I think it's going to be good for y'all fans and people come out and see it. But I know little fans.
Yeah, when we had our rainout day a few weeks ago, when we got out of school for weather, I went over and watched them practice. Jared Hall is at MTSU, transferred from Tulsa, and talked with Coach McDevitt there. And Jared's doing really well. It's definitely going to be a lot easier to go see him at MTSU than it was out at Tulsa. But he's, you know, he's doing well. Texted with him a little bit yesterday. They scrimmage UT Martin this weekend, and then they open up. I think the day that we start practice will be their first game. So definitely looking forward to being able to watch him a lot closer by. Yeah, with just having three seniors, I tell you what, these guys have done a really good job from a leadership standpoint in this offseason. They're all with us. None of those three are playing football. So they've really set the tone for our guys day in and day out. They stand in the gym, you know, leading in from a conditioning and in the weight room standpoint. I'd expect a lot of out of these three guys, especially with as many guys as we did have play last year. Last year we were as we mentioned, we were extremely young. But I do think that with what these guys and their experience that they bring to the table, that we have a chance to be very competitive. Like everybody said, I think on the boys' side, the league's very open. I mean, you know, night in and night out, if you don't bring it, you're going to go home with a loss. There's a lot of really good coaches in this league. But I do feel like, you know, I wouldn't say we're – last year with as young as we were, I don't really feel like we're young anymore. But it is nice to just have three seniors, and we're way further along right now at this point than we were at last season.
He asked a question, too. About you and Corey. I can't help but say I'm sure Tommy of Campbell Brandon and Hester Gibbs together, I won't say,
around 26, 27
years.
And no comparison.
Well... the court and the gym are named after those guys, so we got a lot to live up to along those lines. But
it's a lot easier to get along with.
So, but yeah. I think there's only been four boys coaches at Lebanon High School since 1965 between Coach Gibbs, Coach Seto, Coach Kyle, and myself. So
I get along with
three of them. That's right.
Hey, thanks, fellas.
Thank you.
Coach Carter, who are the kids you got with you today?
Trinity Ryan, senior, and Jada Starn, senior.
Okay. Third year as the head coach at Laverne.
Yes.
All season, how has that gone?
Very competitive. Probably the best summer we've had up to this point, going into my third year. A lot of growth, a lot of good competition. Got stronger conditions at probably the best level we've had at this point. So I'm excited for this coming season.
It's really kind of a short run-up once real practice starts to when you guys start playing. So the off-season work that you do is so important, isn't it?
Yes, and that's why, you know, going into year three, having that kind of the strong competition that we had this off-season is only going to make us better and we struggled last year, very excited for what we've done up to this point. Got some new coaches on the staff, so it's always good to have extra set of eyes to help. And really excited about these two up here with me. You know, as coaches, everybody thinks that, you know, we have favorite players, and I think most of us agree that we don't have that, but I couldn't ask for two harder workers than what we have up here with me. Bought in from day one. Trinity is one of those kids that's going to outwork everybody. She's going to do everything that's asked. If I ask her to run through that brick wall, she's going to run through it and not ask me why I ask her to do it. And Jada's taking on a different leadership role this year. She's holding everybody accountable, whether it's at the track or in the weight room. She holds everybody accountable and to a different standard. So excited for what these two are bringing to the team this year.
Trinity, what's the mindset of the girls coming in and wanting to have a better year this coming year than you had last year? What's going through your head?
Really, it's just all trusting each other and working hard, really. And we push each other every practice, like conditioning and in the weight room. We push each other to become better every single day because we want to have a better season this year. So, yeah.
Jada, talk about leadership and what you try to bring to your team. And you talked about on the track, in the weight room, in the gym, that sort of thing. Is it tough being a leader?
Yeah, because sometimes you got to know how your teammates operate and how they, like, move, because if you don't, it causes discord, and it's something you got to hold people accountable. So that's what I do.
And coaching girls is a little different. They got to get along, right? I mean, that team building is kind of a big part of it, isn't it, Coach?
Yes, sir. This summer was at Freed-Hardeman Camp, and we're 2-0 going into the, you know, on the center court for the last game against another team out of Alabama that was 2-0, and had a little bit of conflict in between games, and we didn't go out there and put our best team on the court, and it showed. So it's just something that, you know, we try to do through team bonding, or through in the weight room class, or at the track, just trying to pull for each other and make each other stronger as a whole.
And that's kind of a learning process for the kids, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Something we try to talk about every day, teach every day. And again, having some assistant coaches this year that have some prior head coaching experience and played at a college level has definitely brought a different aspect to the team as well.
Talk about the non-district schedule that you've got, because we don't have a bunch of teams in this district. You have to get some games before Christmas before the real serious stuff starts.
Yes, sir. We open up with Marshall County. Hall of Fame game, then we go to Ravenwood, and I think we're at Independence. So Marshall County is always a feisty team. Before I got back into coaching, I was refereeing out in that district, officiating, and I know kind of how they play and their style of play. And then for Thanksgiving, we go to Ezel Harding, and then for Christmas, we go to Independence. So last year, with our boys' team being as good as they were, you know, we had a very tough schedule. Some coaches will play different opponents with their girls and guys. Coach Rutland and myself, we work, you know, got a really good working relationship. And so we kind of keep that same schedule for the most part. So whatever he's playing, we're playing, and vice versa. So this year, again, with him being talented like they are, the competition only gets stronger every year.
Do the kids in the school understand how much work that your girls put in? Do you have support from the students? I know everybody wants to watch the guys play because they're running around jumping and dunking the ball and all that kind of stuff. Have the kids caught on to what your girls do?
No, sir. That's something I wanted to change when I took over the program, because I've been at Laverne for 15 years, third year coaching girls, and that's something I wanted to change. And this year I'm excited for what we've done this summer. I think we're going to bring a different brand this year. Hopefully we play a little bit more relaxed and not outthink ourselves. A lot of times we get in our own way. We just don't play freely, and we overthink things. And so hopefully this year we can get people in the crowds early, because our guys are always fun to watch. Coach Rutland does a great job with them. But hopefully we're going to give something a different flavor this year with the girls program.
Well, you did. I think that's the girls.
Yes, Yes, sir. Again, I don't know that anybody's going to outwork us. I mean, this district is loaded. We've all talked about it. Great coaches, great players. But I put our work ethic against anybody's. These two, for sure, they're going to outwork anybody. So hopefully we're going to generate some excitement this year, and they can come in. And once we do that early on, maybe they'll get in there at 6 o'clock instead of waiting until 7:15. Yes, sir. We're still. I mean, we've got 6 juniors, 2 seniors, a couple of sophomores, a couple of freshmen. So we're still. This is the most experienced team I've had up to this point. Had a few transfers come in, so we're excited to see where that goes. But again, with the tough district that we have, every night's a battle. Two-sided. It's tough because someone who was raised by a military father, you expect things done the right way. So if you have two guys both in lead position, you know somebody's wrong. And so that's the frustrating part. And with the same thing being said, I've also told our girls, you know, they don't talk to officials. That's my job as a coach, and we're all human. At every elite professional sport level now, you have instant replay for a reason. So the hit or miss calls that could go both ways, you let them go. But if you feel like, you know, you may be on the short end of the straw with calls, that's my job to stand up for them. And once they see that I'm going to fight for them, they're going to do the same thing for myself in this program. So it makes it a challenge sometimes. But as long as they're hustling and in position, that's the only thing you can ask from a coach when you're talking about officials. Yeah, I don't lose very well. That's something that I'm trying to work on to this day and age. And I set the record straight. Lonnie's 1-27 against me, so he got me one time. So he lost 27. So he knows I don't lose very well and didn't experience very much. But it's something I've continued to work on. We've not had the success there at Laverne like I would have liked to have. First year we won 10 games, you know, lost a lot of talent from that group. Last year was not very good, was not very fun. And again, playing the tough schedule that our guys have and the district components that we have made it even tougher. But we fought, we grew, and like I said, I'll take these girls against anybody. It's a joy to come in and work every day. I think everybody in here can agree that teaching in this generation is extremely tough. And I think a lot of us kind of look forward to when that 3:30 bell hits to go out there and practice basketball, because that's what gets me through the day sometimes. I mean, I teach PE, but it's difficult teaching this generation. But my excitement level steps up another notch when it comes to 3:30 and we get to start practicing in a couple weeks.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Coach Rutland, thanks for being here. Introduce your guys, please.
I have senior here, Landon Bryant, and junior Sherman, Stephen Sherman.
24-10 last year, state quarterfinals. How has last year's success taken you through the offseason to where you are right now?
Last year was last year. We understand it was last year, but at the end of the day, we got to put that in the past and continue to work to get back to where we were. But a lot of the guys were still on that high, and I had to bring them back to reality real quick and understand that they didn't do anything special. But it's always harder to get back to the state championship, and nothing is given to anybody. So we have to go back like we didn't make it and work harder than we did last year.
And getting there is tough. Returning is oh so tough. Is that a mindset you have with these guys now as you get ready to start the real practice grind? Or is it just, hey, let's just get better every day?
Our mindset is get better every day. But when we played Independence in the glass house, if they didn't get that tingle in their stomach, then they have to understand that they're not really basketball players. So if they don't want to get back to that area, I might have to move on and get somebody who wants to be there. So they know my mindset. I'd rather lose with somebody who's going to compete and do the things that we ask them to do rather than just give somebody time because he's a senior or a junior. But they know my mentality, and they know that they have to work hard.
Brandon, you ready for basketball practice to really get going? Because I know you're doing, you get in the gym, you shoot, you lift, and all that kind of stuff. But when it really gets going, is that something you're looking forward to, getting there in the gym with you guys?
Yes, sir. We're like hungry dogs right now. We're trying to get back to that state. Not even going to state, winning state. We're trying to get back there.
What's your team, what do you guys do well? What do you think that your guys really do well on a Tuesday or a Friday night?
Everybody know their role, so everybody not going. They know what to do. So if everybody going to play their role, you know, play defense, and we're going to win games.
Defense, a big part of the basketball mentality there in Laverne. Talk about that.
Yeah, I feel like our defensive mindset is just like if we get stopped, it'll lead to our offense, and we'll really just get out and run out of defense. We don't really got to run that many sets, so it'll just carry us on the offensive end.
Guard and get easy buckets at some point.
Yeah, everybody just run the lanes and score from there.
Coach, talk about the district, solid, tough, competitive teams you're going to be playing outside the district.
Of course, I think our district really prepared us for last year, playing Cookeville numerous times, 4 or 5 times, playing the tough guards that we played at Lebanon and Wilson Central. So everything that we did, and kind of like my schedule, is to try to prepare us for the postseason. We're going to Arkansas again. We played 2 state finalists or champions last year, and the schedule's not out this year, so we'll be traveling there. Kind of have a national holiday classic coming up in December, where we got teams from Texas, Georgia, and Chattanooga teams around. So
where will that be?
It'll be at our school. Okay. It's going to be the Allen Iverson Classic. It'll be December 27th and the 28th. I haven't really put the schedule out, but the schedule is out. But we do have a lot of great teams coming in, and it should be 2 days of great basketball.
Well, and coming off the year that you've had, it might be tough to find some non-district games playing tournaments like this, though. Really, that's a tough go for you.
It is, but I think, you know, when I first got in, you know, we were the hunters, and I want them to keep that same mentality. But now with the success that we've had, you know, we become the hunted. And I tell them all the time, don't change your mentality. Always continue to be the hunters. And we have to get better every day. Again, what we did last year was in the past, but, you know, we want to play the best teams. And we want to get better. Win or lose, if we can get better every day, you know, that's our motto. But, you know, again, it's a marathon, not a sprint. How we start off is not how we hopefully not the end.
Do you do a lot in the weight room with these guys?
No, not.
Or do they do much when they're in there?
No, I give them credit. They do enough. I'm not really into the heavy weights right now. A lot of plyometrics, and I think you see a lot of colleges and pros are going to stuff like that. But, you know, when they go out there, they work. They don't want to be out there, but they do it. You see improvements every day with their jumping abilities and, you know, able to dunk and stuff like that. But when you look at certain private schools, you know, they're in the weight room. You see, you know, their bodies changing. But
Again, it's a mindset. You don't have to be the biggest person to play the strongest. So it's just a matter of knowing how to play the game. So, you know, that's what I'm trying to teach the guys. It has nothing to do with your ability or your strength. It's just knowing your basketball IQ.
Fellas,
Coach,
I know you got a lot of assists and players.
I think it was great. The season last year was more to more than basketball. You know, anytime you can have over 600 students come into the glass house and enjoy themselves and cheer us on. I think we had one of the biggest student sections to come in. But, you know, again, all last year was bigger than basketball. And, you know, coming from our first year where we won only four games to making it in, it's a process. And last year, Dante, who graduated, he was one of my first guys that came in. So, you know, we laid the foundation and we should know what it takes to be successful. But again, with all the changes, with all the districts, all the different teams, nothing is easy. You can't be guaranteed to get to state.
Yeah, I know your schedule last year. I mean, Arkansas seemed like, you know, that trip. I mean, I think I got the finals, that tournament, 20 all games, in overtime, every place. I think that tournament, maybe, I don't know if it's the rest of the season, but I think that really prevailed y'all.
Yeah, you know, me formerly playing basketball, I understand that, like, when you take road trips, the teams grow a bond together. And I think that was the biggest thing that they were able to do is gather that bond going to Arkansas. We had the game, we didn't win, but it taught us a lesson. So I think this year, you know, we had a chance. I mean, we shot over 70% from the three in the first half and was down 12 to Independence.
Yeah.
It was details, scouting report details. So that's the biggest thing. You know, we lost by 12, and this year we're going to pay attention more to the details. So we got to learn.
What'd you say, sir? Yeah, I'm looking to play college ball.
I know you're great. I really haven't seen it. How proud of you? See, I know you're the best brother's on.
Yes, sir.
How proud of you this summer? You watch it. Who you watch it more? You had to stay here. Play football. You know,
yeah.
Y'all want the few schools. Yeah. Hey, y'all make it right now. Y'all want the few schools. Same to the seat. The last two of them.
Yeah.
Charlie.
Yeah, it's quite the experience for my family. Knowing that he made it to Olympics, it was kind of like a crazy moment. Like, everybody was happy, everybody was watching. So, yeah, it's like an all eyes on him moment. So, it's just cherish the moment and just live on from it.
I'm still looking for those athletes, but, you know, I don't. I heard about them, but I haven't seen them.
You talk to Johnny. He has no job.
Yeah.
Thanks, fellas. We appreciate it. Brian, I see you in here. And anytime football travels in this district, it's always a long, long haul.
Lebanon's not bad.
Coach, if you would introduce your kids.
Macy Hudson, who's a senior, and Kendall McLeod, senior.
26-4 last year, region semifinals, district champs. You had good success, but you're always looking for more at football, right?
Yeah, we had been to the state tournament 2 years, and so to not get back last year kind of stung a little bit. we had a lead against Oakland in that last game, and Allie Gillis went down, and we lost in overtime. So it was just a stinger to end your season that way, but it's the game we play.
Talk about the competition in this district, how you better be ready to bring it most every night.
Yeah, you're talking about the reclassification coming up. In 7 years, this is my third district. And so this was, last year was our first year with Smyrna and Laverne. So just, I feel like every other year I'm having to, you know, figure out new teams. Laverne and Smyrna weren't teams that we played before because of the distance. And so now we've got a year under our belt with them playing. Lebanon's always, you know, a tough game. Stewart's Creek was really competitive for us last year. Wilson Central, you know, they're going to continue to get better, like, you know, because they're so young and moving forward. So, you know, you're definitely going to have to bring it every night. I'm glad that we play in the after Christmas district play because it gives you that time to prepare and get ready for, you know, this district that we're in.
And I mentioned it before. Once practice actually starts, official practice, you don't have a lot of time to get ready for games. So what you do in the off season is important. Talk about your off season.
I mean, we had a good summer, and then coming back, we start lifting right when school starts back, and we start with some open gyms, and then after Labor Day, we start conditioning, and just really amped it up after fall break, getting in the gym, you know, with open gyms and things like that. But, you know, we lift 3-4 times a week, do plyometrics a lot, and so I think they're ready for practice to start just so we can stop running.
Kendall, talk about your role with this basketball team this coming season. What's going to be your big contribution?
Definitely coming up, I feel like keeping the team together. Like, since we lost a few people and, like, me stepping up, I feel like taking the leadership role of, like, the lower class and putting them in a new spot to, like you can do this and be confident in them, like, confidence through the team together. I think that we all need to help each other with all that.
Casey, kind of the same thing. What are you going to bring to the table Tuesday nights, Friday nights when you guys play?
Every year I've had a different role for the team. So I think this year a big part will be leadership, like Kendall said. We have a really strong and big freshman class, so I think it's important to show them just how to hustle every play, get every 50-50 ball, do all the little things like Coach preaches, and just show the whole team that we need to play together to be a good season.
Will there be some ninth graders on the floor that we'll see with you guys, or is...
There's the potential to be. Lily McCarter, our other senior, tore her ACL halfway through the summer. So she's rehabbing, coming back. Hopefully she'll be back January-ish. She was a big loss for us. She had a really good summer before she got hurt. And so when that happened, some freshmen had to step up in summer games, and Sadie Garrett's a name that she should get quite a bit of time. I feel like she's I've got the Prescott Middle School team won the state championship last year, so I've got all of those kids who came in, and we got a really good freshman class. We went from having 12 total on our team to 21 with 10 in our freshman class. So we're excited, really excited about that younger class.
And having a theater with some success is huge.
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, Coach Rachel Vann is the coach there, and also have Allgood and Avery Trace, but Rachel and I are good friends. My kids played for her, and so it's huge, the kids that come to me and they're already ready to play. Like, that's a big deal.
Again, talk about your pre-Christmas, pre-district schedule, some folks that you've got.
It's going to be pretty tough. We've got York, and of course they're without Reese Beatty the first time we play them. We'll get to see her in February. We got Knox Webb, Farragut, a lot of East Tennessee teams. For some reason, teams this side of us don't like to travel to Cookeville for some reason. But so we've got some East Tennessee teams. We play Knox Webb, Farragut. Who else is on there?
McMinn Central.
No, not Sparta. Not because we didn't try. Anyway, who?
McMinn Central.
Oh, yeah, we Hall of Fame at Man Central, we started out with them last year. We play Stone, so I feel like...
You talk about different districts through the years. Really, Cookeville's kind of isolated out there. They push and pull you in different directions.
Yeah, we're just a really large school out in the middle of nowhere. And so we don't mind this district. Like Lebanon and you know, Wilson Central's pretty close. Laverne and Smyrna is a hike for us, but you know, I'm glad the district's not Laverne anymore. District tournament. That's late nights on school nights.
I'm gonna ask you, Coach. I know when you talked about that, but the issue that you can't invite anything to Laverne again, they're from that crowd. Is that really what the last couple years on the business district? Is that really y'all can all travel and all that we went up and y'all that's from the bar department?
Yeah, I mean, my first year, Ray County was in our district, so we went to a different time zone. So, I mean, we're used to that. The district before this, we had Green Hill and Mount Juliet. They were closer.
Yeah.
But, I mean, we're used to an hour and a half drive time, you know, one way. So, we don't usually take buses. We get vans just because it's not always great.
I know I was on the players. I know that was a better home last year. I had a lot of home games before Christmas. One of them was
Yeah. We do, yeah. Yep.
That was a really tough loss for us, and it was really hard on our seniors because we wanted to go far for them, but it's definitely on our minds this season, and we're excited to play them for sure.
I mean, we figure it out. We make it work. I have two in college, actually, and two on the team this year. Now I have a freshman this year, too. So, I mean, I think I get better with every daughter. Like, I was really bad with my oldest one, and I'm maybe by my last one, I'll be a good coach to her. So, I don't know. It's tough.
Coach, you kind of touched on it already a little bit, but, you know, depth has always been a really big thing for your team. Do you feel like you have similar depth, better depth, worse depth than usual?
I do. I mean, we lost Isabel Garcia, who was our post player, and she was a big piece of our team last year, and two other seniors. But we're bringing back four starters and like I said, a good freshman group. And so I think depth-wise we'll be okay. We're just small.
That was my very next question is, you know, she had a big inside presence, you know, how do you go about trying to replace that?
Well, I don't mind playing five guards ever. You know, we'll have to figure some things out defensively, how we want to guard posts and things like that. But, you know, we're not real big, but we're skilled and we're going to be in really good shape. And so, you know, I feel like that's our best way to go about it this year, just not being as big as we have been. And basketball in the Upper Cumberland is really, really good. And the issues we face are a lot of those smaller schools don't want to play us because I guess we're supposed to win, you know. But we love that competition. We try to get them every year. And, you know, with the boys having as much success as they did last year, it was even harder to get those smaller schools to come and want to play boys and girls. We are traveling to Pickett County this year, and you know, they're defending state champions in single A. And so I think that'll be a really good game. So, you know, those small schools travel really well, and so it's always a fun atmosphere and a great gate. It's just hard getting them to there, but just because I think there's a stigma that we are so big, but you know, they're usually really good games when we can get them. Coach Johnny Morgan and I started talking before last year, year before last, and we wanted our teams to play against each other. He's got a really good program there, and And so we just worked out, Roan State is about the halfway point for us. And so for either one of us having to travel the 2.5 hours, we can each go about 1 hour and 15. And so we just meet in the middle there. And it's a pretty cool environment to get to play in. And this year our boys are going with us, so it'll be even better.
Anybody else? Thank you, guys.
Thanks.
Appreciate it. Coach Hill, first year head coach, longtime assistant. No big deal stepping in, taking over for a program that went to the state finals last year, right?
Yeah, no big deal. Small shoes to fill. No, I'm good.
What? This is a great opportunity for you to get the number one job. Talk about that process.
The process of getting it?
Yeah. And your mindset saying, hey, I want to do this.
Yeah, well, it was kind of a whirlwind. There late July, I guess. Coach Hurd, kind of called and brought us in as coaches and just told us, hey, this is something we're thinking about doing as a family, moving. So, yeah, from there it was, just a couple of days and talking to admin and I guess just kind of made sense timing-wise. And there wasn't a ton of hesitation for me. I mean, I've got roots there. I played in Cookeville and been around ever since I played, so I'm excited. But yeah, timing wise it was tough, but it's kind of behind me now. I'm ready to get started.
Off season work, how did that go?
Yeah, so I mean, obviously the summer was under Coach Hurd, and Joe was with us. Joseph Owens, by the way, like introduce them. Joseph Owens and Jaron Davis, both seniors, two seniors we got. Joe's in football a lot. I think we got him for 4 or 5 games this summer. And Jaron was kind of in and out, just kind of nursing some leg stuff. But it was good. I mean, we traveled to Freed and obviously down to Memphis with the B-Cat. And got in a lot of work. But at the same time, again, it was, under Coach Hurd and his son was with us at that time. So don't know a whole lot as far as coming into the season. We've been working out and playing open gym and that kind of thing. But I can't wait till November.
Do you have a style you want to play with these guys? Will folks notice a big difference?
Yeah, I joked with somebody the other day, before we get the shot clock in, I'll go – four corners, Dean Smith, Coach Faye said 13-12 earlier, something like that. No, it's like everybody else. It's kind of adjust to what your guys are good at. Obviously, there's some things, some standards you have as a program, and all of those won't change as far as defense, defensive effort and things like that. But no particular style.
Joseph, you've been able to get some work in being – involved with football and being able to get in the gym a little bit and get some shots up?
Yeah, I'm able to shoot from like time to time and stuff like that, but I'm mainly focused on football right now.
And being in the weight room so much with football, does that carry over well to what you want to do in basketball?
Definitely. I've gotten a little bit bigger since last year, just being in the weight room for football. And also just the physicality of football, it helps. Just being like a little undersized, but having to play against some bigger dudes, like in the paint and stuff like that. So
it makes you a little stronger setting up screens, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Jaron, talk about your role on this basketball team. Going forward, will it be basically what you've done in the past, or are you taking on some new responsibilities?
For sure, taking on some new responsibilities. I mean, we lost 4 key guys last year, so I mean, and they were all leaders, every single one of them, so. Definitely going to have to be more of a leader and definitely be more of a leader for sure.
Is that something you look forward to?
Yes, sir.
New responsibility?
Yes, sir.
Coach, outside district play, what have you got?
Yeah, so Coach Gillis was kind of talking about it. We got to drive quite a bit, going to East Tennessee, playing Knox Webb twice, and Coach Norris. We kind of use that every year for as a measuring stick for us. Because every year he's going to have a state caliber team, Farragut, Oakland, Hendersonville. Coach talked about going. We drive to Pickett County, and if you've never played at Pickett County, that is as far as basketball environments, they love basketball up there. That'll be fun. So yeah, and couple holiday tournaments that we always like. You know, everybody's talked about, you know, bonding and things like that. So.
Bell, some questions. I want to ask you, Joseph. You play football. You got a big day tonight over at Green Hill.
Yes, sir.
Are you just gonna hang out, loving all weekend, let them pick you up? And that's a lot of driving back and forth on the interstate one day.
I might have to. But yeah, I'm excited about that game tonight. It's a big game for us.
Yeah, let me say, Coach Hennigan was nice to let him drive down. I made sure and asked him, and you know, obviously Joe wanted to be a part of this, and so Coach Hennigan's great to let him come down, and we're gonna try it. We got a hard out at 1 o'clock, so we got to get him back.
He's
got to get back to come back. Yeah, yeah.
How's that for the players?
Yeah, I mean, it was a lot of fun. I mean, obviously, none of us have experienced anything like that. I mean, past years we've lost the first round of region. So, I mean, going to state, that was awesome. And to do it with that group of guys was definitely special. Oh, yeah, no, that was special. That was awesome. I mean, I've never seen Cookeville people get out like that and support. I mean, that was awesome.
Were you almost at my view?
Yeah, just like Jaren said, it was a crazy atmosphere. It just felt good to see everybody come out and support us that night. It was just a great atmosphere for us.
What was my plan for my last night? I hope that you play on Power 4. I get a little bit lighter on that. That's good for you.
Yeah, it was awesome. I mean, I think we broke the record for most people, right?
That's what they said.
That's what they said. I mean, it was like 5,000 people or something like that, 4,000 people. So, I mean, it was nice.
Talk about style of play a little bit. What about culture? I mean, I know you've been with the program for a long time. Do you have any plans to change anything with the culture, or is it going to stay pretty much the same?
No, not a lot. You know, I think we've kind of got expectations in place, and obviously, you know, those turned out to work pretty well. So, no, not changing a whole lot, and you know, staff is pretty much all together. Kept my assistant coaches around, thankfully. So. No, but as far as the day-to-day things like that, other than obviously Jaren stepping up as a leader, culture-wise, no, it's not a whole lot of turnover.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.